Hey guys, today I'm going to be reviewing the Bronze Horseman trilogy by Paulina Simons, consisting of The Bronze Horseman, Tatiana and Alexander, and The Summer Garden. The Bronze Horseman takes place in Leningrad, Russia, and follows the Medinov family. And the story starts on June of 1941, when Russia pretty much enters World War II. So on the first day of the war, Tatiana, her father, wants her to go out to get their rations because they're worried that all the rations, now that war has started, all the rations will just immediately disappear. So Tatiana, while she is out, she gets distracted and she ends up eating some ice cream instead. And while she's sitting on the bench, that is when she lays eyes on a Russian soldier named Alexander Belov. And from there on out, Tatiana and Alexander, they have kind of this forbidden love going on because Alexander is dating Tatiana's sister, Dasha. Not only do Tatiana and Alexander have to keep their love a secret from her sister, but they also have to deal with the trauma and horrors of World War II, which takes them into the midst of the blockade on Leningrad, where they deal with starvation and extreme cold. The Bronze Horseman is just one of my all-time favorites when it comes to Russian historical fiction. Not only is it a great history piece, but also a great romance. All three of these books are simply stunning. Paulina Simons, wow, what an amazing author. She can write characters extremely well. She's also just brilliant at descriptions, not over describing things, but giving you just enough detail that you love it. And she also certainly knows how to make you feel the horrible conditions that all of these characters have to go through. Like I said, the blockade at Leningrad, the characters have to go through starvation and extreme cold. And when I read The Bronze Horseman, every time, I find myself starving and freezing. It's just so eerie. And Paulina Simons is just amazing at those descriptions. I will warn you about some things with these books because I think it's important to know what you're getting into with these books. Like I said, they are historical fiction. They take place during World War II. Things in all three books can get pretty graphic and chaotic. There's lots of blood, missing limbs sometimes. Like I said, you have people starving, you got people freezing. There's just some really graphic images going on. And the story is also a romance. So Tatiana and Alexander, when you do get to some of the sex scenes, they can be pretty graphic, especially with the language they're using with one another. And Paulina Simons, sometimes this is a bit of a negative with the sex scenes, but she will go at length with the sex scenes and you will get every single little detail that you did not want to know about. So sometimes the sex scenes will be just really great, you'll love how they're written, but then other times the sex scenes will kind of be like, you just want her to stop. They can get a little too much on occasion. Another thing to understand when you go into this trilogy, Tatiana and Alexander, they are not perfect characters. They are massively flawed characters. And sometimes you will find yourself not really liking them so much, even though they are the protagonist of this story. Tatiana is a very confusing character on occasion. Sometimes she comes across as a Mary Sue, meaning someone who has no flaws and everyone loves her. Sometimes she'll come across that way. And other times she'll come across as just way too naive and sometimes idiotic. And you often wonder, what the hell is she doing when she should be doing something else? And then Alexander, sometimes you're like, ooh, I love him so much. But then other times his obsessiveness and his compulsions and just who he kind of is deep down inside will kind of spring out. And it's all kind of shocking. And he can be a bit abusive, both physically and verbally. And sometimes you just really hate Alexander and you don't understand why he's doing the things he's doing sometimes. And sometimes you hate how he treats Tatiana on occasion. Sia, I think that's important to note going into these books because Tatiana and Alexander, you kind of have a love-hate relationship with them. As far as the books go, The Bronze Horseman is definitely my favorite in the trilogy. It is what starts off the whole series. It's the reason why I love these characters. And then the second book in the series, Tatiana and Alexander, wow, definitely right up there with The Bronze Horseman, I think. I wish I can go into more detail about what happens in this book, but it is amazing. You just really feel for these characters. You are on this journey with them, whether that be for good or bad. And just like with The Bronze Horseman, just more graphicness and tragedy everywhere. Then let's talk about The Summer Garden, the final book in the trilogy. In some ways, I wish that The Bronze Horseman was just a duology. If the series had stopped after book two, I would have been perfectly happy with that because book three, it is very testing on the reader and it really puts you through a lot. And there were times I just wanted to put this damn book down. I was getting so fed up, so annoyed. And the thing is, like I said, I love Tatiana and Alexander's characters, flaws and all, but this book just seems to be nothing but their flaws, and it was very annoying. So yeah, what I guess I'm trying to say is that book three was a disappointment. It wasn't necessarily bad, just more of a disappointment more than anything. Because Paulina Simon's writing was still gorgeous. But as you can see, this book is pretty huge, pretty lengthy. I think a lot could have just been cut out. Like I said, you could have just had a duology and it would have been great. I think what my problem might be with this book is the fact that these two books are very historical. There's a lot of historical context going on in these books besides just the romance and how the characters fit within this historical context. But with this book, without giving away any spoilers, I just feel like there's no historical context, and that is what was missing. It seems like this whole book is just nothing but their relationship, which got monotonous and tedious, and you just hated their relationship the majority of this book. I was really expecting this book to do something differently. I was expecting some certain things to happen to place it within a historical context, and nothing happened in this book. Overall, The Bronze Horseman trilogy is a stunning and epic trilogy, despite my issues with the third book. But still, this trilogy is worth a read for at least the first two books. If you're just not in the mood to read all three of these books, I think if you just read the first and second book, it's perfectly okay because you're not really going to be missing anything with the third book. But yeah, a stunning epic trilogy, the best in historical fiction, especially if you like things set in Russia during World War II. A fantastic set of characters, not only Tatiana and Alexander, but all the characters surrounding them, whether you love them or hate them, including the two main characters. So that's it for this review. Have any of you read the Bronze Horseman books? If you have, please feel free to talk with me about them in the comments below. Also, if you want to get into spoilers. So that's it for this book review. I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And if you liked this book review, you may like these other book reviews. Bye, guys.